In this video, I will take you through HTS initial form. Now that our patient is eligible for testing, click on the HTS initial form as displayed. Complete the HTS testing dates. From the calendar menu, pick the year, month, and date, which by default will be highlighted. In the population type section, select the population type from the radio button, either general population, which is an end to itself, key population, then select the checkboxes from the displayed options, priority population, select the population type from the displayed option. Select if the client has any disability. If you select yes, indicate the type of disability from the checkboxes. If you select no, proceed to the HIV test history section. Remember, this form is completed as the patient is being interviewed. HIV test history. You inquire if the client has ever been tested by HTS provider. For our case here, Stacy has not been tested by HTS provider. If at all she had been tested before, you will select the radio button yes and specify the duration of months in the highlighted text field. Has the client done HIV self-test in the last 12 months? For our case, it's no. HTS strategy. Select from the drop-down menu the strategy to be used. For our case here, this is a provider-initiated test. The entry points. Select the entry points. Stacy came through the outpatient department. HIV testing. So at this point now, we want to proceed to testing. The next section is HIV testing. You find out from the client if they have consented to be tested or not. For our case here, Stacy has consented to be tested. We select the yes radio button. If not, if at all Stacy had not consented to test, once you select the radio button no, all the other fields are grayed out, and that is the end of the session. But for our case, Stacy consented to be tested, so we'll select yes to proceed with our testing session. At that point, as the HTS provider, you will ascertain if Stacy is tested as an individual or a couple. If Stacy is accompanied by the spouse, then it becomes couple testing. You select couple testing radio button. But for our case, Stacy walked in as an individual. So we'll select individual. Then we'll proceed to conduct the test. The first test, you'll select from the drop-down menu the result of the first test. For this learning purpose, we'll select positive. Then we fill the kit name that was used. The first kit name for the first test was determined. Then we'll prefill the lot number, which is usually written on the test kit. The lot number can be gotten from the box that the test kits come with. Then the expiry date or the field on the expiry date. If expired, definitely the guidelines guide, we don't use expired kits. So basically, the expiry date is a date in the future. After the first test, as the HTS provider, you'll proceed to conduct the second test. Select the results of the second test. For a case, for this learning purpose, we'll select positive. The kit name that was used, first response, the lot number, and expiry date, which is usually in the future, according to our guideline. So, immediately you prefill the second result test, the final test is auto-populated. Remember, our first test was positive, our second test was positive, Therefore, the system will auto-populate our final test as positive. Okay, suppose the second test turns out to be negative, then the final results become inconclusive. So, let us get back to our usual scenario of a positive result. After the final results, indicate whether the result was given to the patient by responding to a yes or no. For our purpose in this training, we'll respond to yes. Remember, Stacy was tested as an individual. Therefore, the coupled discordant response becomes not applicable. The next section is on TB screening. Select the option according to your clinical findings. The next section is the remarks section. This is where you as the HTS provider will indicate the remarks during the testing phase. For example, for a case here, Stacy accepted the test outcome. After completing the remarks section, submit the form by clicking Enter Form. After clicking the Enter Form button, did you notice that the recorded HTS initial form has been added under the completed visit forms panel? You guessed right. So in our next video, I'm going to take you through the HTS retest form.